Redfall, Cyberpunk, Starfield, Payday 3, City Skylines 2, Dead Matter, and even the famous and great Red Dead Redemption 2 have something in common. They get incredibly hyped, except for some certain examples of course, have an enormous price of up to 110 euros or US dollars, and at the end of the day, they are a broken mess or incredibly boring at release. And while I read people on X saying they would even spend 300 euros for GTA 6, I have the question, is it actually worth buying a game if it has to be fixed anyway? And my clear answer would be no, but there's a reasoning why. I've always been a supporter of the gaming industry, as it is my hobby, and gaming is one of my personal forms of entertainment. There are games I have spent hours over hours in, some would say too many hours, and I still even play classic games such as Age of Empires 2 or Civilization with friends in multiplayer. Why? They are fun and they just work flawlessly. Sure, some of them are incredibly unbalanced, but still they are fun to play. Even Cyberpunk and Red Dead Redemption 2 got fixed and are absolutely worth playing by now. I do not have to edit any files, wait for patches, tweak here and there to have some sort of stable gaming experience. I just come home from work, sit in front of the PC and spend my free time having fun. And that is what gaming should be all about. It is difficult though to find where the problem lies. I don't want to necessarily blame a dev team. They get paid to write lines of code, create assets, music, video sequences, voiceovers, be creative and more. All of this takes a tremendous amount of time, and when looking at the state at release, it more feels like some kind of mismanagement. You can't tell me that a developer wants to see its creation burn and being torn apart by the public. There might be situations where developing parts of a game is just an outsourced job, a gig somehow, and the dev team doesn't really care, but I don't believe that this is always the case. On the other hand, how is testing going on? We see it on City Skylines 2. Was there any performance and bug testing done before, or were the results just ignored? Or was testing performed by an external company which delivered a false report? Even the bigger media outlets reported way before this game has performance issues, and it feels as if nothing had been done. At least you're moving DLCs until the performance issues are fixed. I've been developing IT-related products myself for some time, and I'm still involved in testing, and even if I'm not working on games, I feel the same pressure. Management sets a date when the product or service needs to go live, and as your manager isn't necessarily listening, you are trying to somewhat bring it into a state where you can pretend with both eyes closed it is running fine. Is it a good feeling? Of course not. You feel like you are betraying your customers, to be honest, but for the upper levels of the company, only sales count. But what can game studios do? Of course, many of them have a publisher breathing into their neck and constantly trying to move them to a release. But also, a broken early access release is not a solution. If you as a customer touch an early access game which barely runs, let's be honest, how high is the chance to ever touch this game again? You play like 2 hours at most and then totally forget about it. It is sitting there in your library, dead. Of course, for a publisher or studio, it is still a win. You gave them your money. And it can't be up to the mod community fix a game every time. Looking at you, Bethesda. Games have to become smaller again, better manageable. It doesn't have to be the next huge open world game. Open world is becoming boring anyway. Also, no one asks to use the very latest techniques in graphics, engine design, which just makes things even more complicated. Personally, I feel there's a decline in graphics quality anyway, if you look at Forspoken, for example. Well, there's something we gamers can do. Don't buy games on day one. And I know it is hard. I want to support my favorite games so they can continue, give me expansions or a sequel. I want to play them as soon as possible. What is the point though, buying a game and then waiting half a year until it is playable? Get the game after the first patches are out. Watch or read some reviews and then decide. Maybe even wait for a sale to save some money. Honestly, we need to make more use of the refund methods the stores give us. If a game has bad critiques for performance and gameplay issues, wait before you buy. As long as you buy their shit, the big studios and publishers will continue with what they are doing. You as a customer deserve better. What do you think? Drop your opinion into the comments below. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye.